In recent years, we have been very much interested in the microbiota, in the relationship of microbes with the human being. And there is a kind of symbiosis because we harbor bacteria and other microorganisms in our body. And those bacteria, they work for us. For instance, they help us in the digestion, or they help us in the stimulation of the immune system. So dysbiosis is a concept that explains a situation where this symbiosis is lost, this kind of rupture. Usually we can recognize it by the composition. It's a change in the composition. And interestingly, this is very common in many modern diseases, the chronic inflammatory diseases in modern world, including type 2 diabetes or inflammatory bowel diseases or obesity. Probiotics are bacteria or other kind of microorganisms that we use with a health purpose. And the criteria are that these microorganisms must be very well characterized. They must be deposited in a collection, and they have to be been tested in studies for safety and for efficacy. They need to be tested in the host in studies where the human beings, they receive the probiotic or the placebo, and you can see the differences in the benefit in the endpoint of the study. And you can demonstrate a benefit, for instance, improvement in the immune system, or for instance, prevention of diarrhea when you use the probiotic as compared to placebo. The advantage of yeast is that yeast are eukaryotic beings, which means that they don't spread, for instance, antibiotic-resistant genes. When we are using a probiotic, which is a bacteria, the bacteria, they might spread genes among other bacteria. Sometimes pathogenic bacteria take antibiotic-resistant genes from other good bacteria, which are not bad bacteria. So in some situations, it's better to have a probiotic being a yeast than having a probiotic being in a bacteria. We see that the human microbiota has changed a lot during the past 20 years or during the past 50 years because of the use of antibiotics. So we are talking now about the missing microbes. So a way of stopping this situation is to use adequate probiotics together with antibiotics each time we need a therapy.